Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Hello, and a very hearty welcome to everyone here. Those who are here in person, those who are perhaps watching online, those who are here for the first time, and maybe a few of you. Many of you have been coming for quite a long time, and some of you have been coming for a lot longer than I have. But a warm welcome to you all on this Mothering Sunday, the fourth Sunday of Lent, as we celebrate motherhood whilst trying to keep a good Lent at the same time. It's a little bit of a contrast. But there we are, you're all very welcome indeed. So we'll start with our call for purity. Almighty God,
to whom all of us serve, all of us thanks come, and from whom mercy trust of you, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Let us call to mind our sin, our failure to value the love of others, and our failure to love as Christ has loved us. Your love gives us life from the moment of conception.
We fail to live as your children.
You call us to do good.
We seek our own good.
You hear us when we cry for help.
We ignore the cries of us.
May the Father of all mercies cleanse you from your sins and restore you in his image to the praise and glory of his name, in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Brought into the house of the Lord the child, and the child was young.
And they sorted the rope, and they brought the child to Eli. And she said, "Oh, my Lord, as you left, my Lord, I am the woman who was standing here in your presence, praying to the Lord. For this child I pray, and the Lord has granted me the petition which I made to him. Therefore, I have lent him to the Lord. As long as he lives, he is given to the Lord." She left him there and told the Lord. This says the word of the Lord.
Yes, please, God.
Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude.
standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Cleopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Samuel, who became a judge to lead Israel. Hannah was childless, and she prayed to God in the tent of meeting for a male child. She promised to dedicate him to God as a Nazirite, so she would not even have him living with her, if only God would provide her with a male child. Well, God listened to Hannah, as we know, and she bore Samuel, whom she dedicated to God, and she left him in the tent of meeting as soon as he was weaned. I can't imagine how painful it must have been for Hannah to keep her promise to God by dedicating her precious only son to God's service and not keep him for herself. However, our extravagant and generous God provided Hannah, as we hear, with three further sons and two daughters. So the sacrifice was not in vain. But what a courageous and painful thing that she did with Samuel, the firstborn. Hannah's love for God led her to keep her vow, no matter how painful it must have been for her as a mother to lose her only child. She had no idea that God would provide her with more children when she married and kept her vow. And then we've heard our psalm, beautifully sung, by our choir, Psalm 137, which reminds us that no matter how hard we work and how well we do, we can only succeed if God wills it and does it for us. We should put our trust in him and not lose sleep worrying about things, for he gives sleep to his beloved. And it reminds us that children are a heritage from the Lord and are like arrows in the hand of a warrior, making a family more powerful and safer. This is indirectly, of course, a tribute to mothers, for without them there would be no children. We've also heard some very good advice on Christian living, given by St. Paul to the church at Colossae. As Christians, we should clothe ourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. How I wish I had all those qualities all of the time. But it is a wonderful thing to aspire to. And to put up with each other's faults, forgiving one another. And that's a very difficult thing to do at times. And that's what leads to conflict, whether family conflict or inter-conflict between countries, as we're having at the moment. But over all these clothes of virtue, you should put on the cloak of love, which binds them all together. And of course, is Jesus' new commandment, to love one another, as he instructed us in John 13, verse 34. St. Paul instructs us to let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, and to worship together with thanks to God, and do everything in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So it's all about love. Love starts in the family. It started with God's family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Trinity is one God in three persons, and they love each other mightily. All love began with God. When God created the world, and particularly humankind, he made in his image, he loved them deeply. He loves us all, deeply. Deeply enough to have sent his only Son to live for us, teach us how to live, and to die for us in payment for every person's sins for all time, so that everyone, if we repent, turn away from sin and wickedness, and turn to Christ, will be forgiven, our slates wiped clean, made innocent before God, and granted eternal life. Now that's love. And he sent us the Holy Spirit to love us and help us and empower us and to enable us to preach the good news of the gospel of Christ to all. Therefore, if God loves us so much, the least we can do is to try and love him back, and especially love other people too. Love starts with a family. We can see this. Moms and dads make every effort to look after their babies and children. Even the poor victims of war in Ukraine and Gaza, living in awful conditions in refugee camps and making horrendous journeys to get there, look after their children. But it is the moms who are the driving force of love in the family. And no mom is more loving than Mary, the mother of Jesus Christ. She was told by the angel Gabriel that her son was going to be called the Son of the Most High, and that his kingdom would have no end. But she was warned, as early as Jesus' presentation in the temple, by Simeon, that a sword will pierce your own soul too, implying tragedy for her in the future. She lived out a life of love and giving, an encouragement for her son, despite knowing deep down that there would be tragedy in the future. Our gospel story today is very short, but it tells us of Jesus on the cross, dying in agony. All his followers have deserted him, except for John, and of course his mom Mary, his sister, Mary the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene, five people in all. All the rest have gone, frightened for their lives, even Peter and James. Jesus, even though he's dying in indescribable agony, asks his mother to take John as her son, and asks John to take Mary as his mother. We are told that John took Mary into his own home from that day onward. This showed the love between Jesus, his mother Mary, and John. It also showed the reverence and love that Jesus had for his mother and for her future welfare. Because even as he was dying in agony on the cross, he took care of her. Now that is love. But family love meant that Jesus' mom and his sister were there, and the others were there out of love for him too. Their love overcame their very real fear of the Romans. In 1 John chapter 4, verse 5, we're told, there is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear. In the same way, love for their children overcomes the fear of Ukrainian and Palestinian and Israeli mothers as they run into danger to save and protect their children. While we are celebrating motherhood and remembering the extreme tragedy for Mary of losing her beloved son, Jesus, we should take a few moments in our quiet time to remember the thousands of other mothers who are mourning the loss of their children, taken before their time, in Ukraine, Russia, Israel, Gaza, and the West Bank, and many other places besides, including in this country, of course. Losing a child is the ultimate tragedy for any mother, and we should look to preventing such events in the world in future, as well, of course, as stopping these wars and this death. Mothers are the mainstay and instigators of love in the family unit. They're there for us from the day we are born. They love us unconditionally until we are parted by death. A mother's love is a wonderful thing, for it is not usually jealous and selfish, but generous and forgiving, encouraging and inspiring. We are shaped by our mothers, and our fathers too, but it is to our mothers that we give homage today. So when we pray our intercessional prayers in a few moments, I ask you all to silently pray a few words for your mom, whether she's still with you or not, and give thanks to God for her. We will, of course, have some flowers for every mom here later this morning, and they are in grateful thanks for their unfailing love for us. Amen. Let us declare our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We believe in one God,
the Father, the Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, and all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made. One being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified and appointed triumph. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge the baptism of the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
As children of a loving God who always listens to our cries, let us pray to our Father in heaven.
As one comforts his mother, so will I comfort you. For he will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you will find refuge. Our Father, we bless you and thank you for creation. smile, especially on this refreshment Sunday. Hear us as we pray for the renewal of your holy church here on earth, in faith, love, and service. For this is the church, our clergy, and our fellow visit here during this interregnum. Guard and strengthen Charles, our King, Queen Camilla, and all the royal family, that they may put their trust in you and seek your honour and glory. We pray for our mothers today, for our babies being born today. We thank you for those who foster or adopt, taking children into their homes to love and care for them. As our Lord grew into manhood and our mother's care, make his church dear to mothers and their children. Give us reverence for all creation and respect for every person, that we may know in your likeness in Jesus Christ, for our hearts are restless till they find rest in you. Give us grace to hear and receive your word, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit. Lord, in your mercy. Compassionate God, we pray for peace in our troubles and world. We hold up to all tensions in the Middle East, for Ukraine and aggression from Russia, for all affected by war and conflict in Gaza, for lives lost, for the many troubles affecting people in other parts of the world, for those still suffering from wildfires, famine and natural disasters. Show your pity on prisoners and refugees. We pray for the abused, the vulnerable, homeless and those living in poverty. We pray for all hospitals and emergency services. Despair turns to hope through your sweet goodness. Through your gentleness we find comfort in the end. In your love and tenderness, we make it. Bring your healing and make us whole once more. Lord, in your mercy. Glory God, bless our homes with care and concern for one another. May our families become as the Holy Family in shared love and worship. Be ever close with the gift of your unfailing love to the mothers and children in our community. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Great physician, we pray for comfort for the aged and the infirm, for the widow and the orphan, for all mothers who are in distress, for those who have lost children through death or estrangement, for those whose children are sick, be it in body, mind, or spirit. Pray for those who have asked for our prayers, for Isabel, Project Isabel. Grant them strength in their affliction and healing for those they love. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Conqueror of death, we remember before you those who have departed of this life, whose faith is known to you alone. Pray for the recently departed, for Bobby Roberts, and for Ray Nolan, Peter Parker, Regina Algimantos, Kaslauskas Algimantos, Winifred Annie Roper, Phyllis Wood, Neville Lester Tucker, and Kathleen Croxall, whose anniversary occurs at this time. We pray for all mothers we remember with love and see no more, but cherish in our hearts. May they be at peace and joy with Blessed Mary and all the saints. Bless and comfort those who mourn. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We pray in the name of Christ, who loves us as a mother loves her children. We commend ourselves and all whom we pray to the mercy and protection of God. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son.
Amen.
through the prophet Isaiah, God says, as a mother comforts her child, so I will comfort you. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. God of wisdom, may the light of your eternal word, our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ, lead us in holiness and guide us to glory. We ask this in his name.
Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Blessed be you, Lord God, our light and our salvation. To you be glory and praise forever. From the beginning, you have created all things, and all your works echo the silent music of your praise. In the fullness of time, you made us in your image, the crown of all creation. You give us breath and speech, that with angels and archangels and all the powers of heaven, we may find a voice to sing your praise. At the end of supper, taking a cup of wine, he gave me thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. We remember his dying and rising in glory, and we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. Pour out your Spirit and bring before you these gifts of your creation, that they may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy things in your presence, form us in the likeness of Christ, and build us into a living temple to your glory. Bring us, at the last, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. George, and all the saints, to the vision of that eternal splendor for which you have created us, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessings
and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen.
Lord Jesus, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Our souls washed through his
Let us pray. Loving God, as a mother feeds her children at the breast, you feed us in this sacrament with the food and drink of eternal life. Help us, who have tasted your goodness, to grow in grace within the household of faith, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God of our pilgrimage, you have fed us with the bread of heaven.
Refresh and sustain us as we go forward on our journey. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. All these verses that I'm going to give, I'm not going to give too many, don't worry, are here in your good sheets. There's no evening service today. The next one will be on the 17th of March at 4:30. The service of hymns and readings for Passion Time. The community choir will be taking place on Monday the 11th of March. So if you'd like to sing, it's open to all, no experience needed. On Friday the 22nd of March, we have an organ recital of Joe Collier from London. On Good Friday, we have the Good Friday liturgy, of course. Monday, Thursday, we've got the lunchtime Eucharist and the plural Choral Eucharist with foot washing. And then on Easter Sunday, we've got the service of light and First Communion of Easter at 6:15 a.m. And I welcome you all cordially to that. Didn't get up in time. But there will be a breakfast afterwards. So if you intend to come and stay for the breakfast, please put your name on the list at the crossing at the back, so we know how many to cater for. This will be bacon, sardines, fruit, yogurt, etc. And if you've got any special dietary requirements, please put them next to your name. We're going to have special flowers for Easter, and we welcome contributions from the congregation towards the cost of these flowers. Finally, we need helpers to welcome people. So if you would like to welcome people as they arrive, it makes such a difference if people are welcome when they come in. Please let us know. We're very short of people, so please speak to Linda Orridge from the church boarders for more information. Everything else is in your sheets. Apart from the Lent reflection, Reverend Susan Bedford writes a Lent reflection each week, and they're available on the table at the crossing. So please pick one. They're very good. Thank you. Now we're going to have the distribution of flowers, but we have a prayer first, prayers first. So the congregation will join in the response. Praise God who loves us.
Praise God who cares.
Loving God, we thank you for mothers, for grandmothers, for godmothers, and for all the people who care for us and who have cared for us. May these flowers be the sign of our thanks and of the love that we all share through you, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.